As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way.
I know Jesus and I knew God because I grew up with my parents both encouraging me to go to church. I didn't speak and I couldn't really walk. I didn't crawl or anything, and they laid hands on me and prayed for me, and I was healed, and I felt God's love so incredibly.
But it was around the age of 12 that I started to think that these things, I still didn't feel like I knew what life was about, that life couldn't have been about having lots of fun or seeing as many places as possible or having the most friends. These things didn't add up, and so I started asking those questions: what is the purpose of life, and what is truth? Is God real?
My father passed away when I was 18, and that definitely hit our family hard, and I was off in college, so I feel like I was not around a lot for my brother and my mother during that time, and I kind of went off to fix my own self by indulging in things that college students shouldn't indulge in, and I kind of lost myself in that stuff for a while. One of my best friends now was a Christian in college, and I just remember looking at her and saying, oh my gosh, who are you, and what do you have, because I want what you are. She just had this loving presence about her. She was just outpouring of love.
My friend invited me to a church that was different than the one I grew up in. They talked about Jesus in a way that to me just blew my mind. He was alive to them. He actually did things in their lives and was active and cared for them deeply, and I could see it in these people. That day, that weekend, the next couple years, my life perspective totally changed. I didn't live for having a lot of fun, having a lot of friends. I actually lost quite a few friends those years because I didn't like the things that they were doing, or they didn't like the new way that I was acting. But I had life.
I was working, and a friend of mine was going to a church that sounded pretty cool. It didn't sound like anything I knew of growing up, and he sounded excited to go to church, and I was like, I'd like to be excited to go to something like that. And I also felt my soul was really just aching. It needed something, it needed community, it needed people. And I think that was a real draw for me, was to get involved with people in a community.
Because of my health complications, my hearing impairment, and my eyesight, I was picked on a lot by other kids. And because of that, I've bent towards God more and more, because I knew that God loved me no matter what.
Christ really led me to different friends and to find fulfillment in Him only, even if I was made fun of, even if friends and family questioned why. Why would you act like this or not be involved in some things that they thought were meaningful? The phrase then, when I was 12, was I always prayed, God, I want you to be the driver and I want to be the passenger. So take my life and do what you want with it.
I came to a breaking point that I haven't had ever. I just was drinking a lot. I thought I was going in the right direction, going to church and doing my Bible study, and I was just being overcome by anxiety and worry and all this grossness that the world brings. And I just one night had it, and I said, all right, Jesus, I've seen what you can do to people, and I just wanted to experience that. From that point on, my life has not been the same. It has been completely transformed. My heart has been completely transformed, and it's all because of Jesus. And that's what I have to say. I think everything building up to it brought me to this point, and for the longest time it was so scary to say even the word, the name Jesus, but now it's just rolls off my tongue and my heart like it always belonged there.
Even though I love God and I knew God, I asked God to let me walk in the world for a little while. I wanted people to like me, even though I knew it was breaking God's heart. That led to depression, suicide attempts, drinking, being assaulted a few times, sexually assaulted, and it really wasn't worth it at all.
Yeah, myself and self-preservation, wanting to have success or wanting to be something is still in me, still something that rears its ugly head when I feel like I don't want to be corrected. I want to be right. I want to be good. And it shows up, pride shows up. The more and more I know Christ, the more and more he draws me near to him, the more exposed my own selfishness, my own pride becomes. And it's a hard thing. It's iron sharpening iron, and that hurts. But it is a good thing, and it is a cleansing process.
I suffer from anxiety sometimes. I was on prescription anxiety medication, and when I decided to give myself to Christ, it was a gradual process, but he just lifted that worry because I didn't have to worry anymore. It all ties into pride because I try to control situations, and I have this vast plan for how I want my life to work and the people I want to touch and have them know Jesus. And I try to live a certain way, which is Christ-like, but sometimes I try to take control and think I've got the right answer when really I don't, and Jesus does. So I always have to remember that and go back to him and say, all right, what do you need me to do? So pride is definitely a struggle of mine.
I did something so horrible. I didn't think that she would forgive me. I didn't think I could really forgive myself. I don't have a ton of friends, and I was praying to God, God, please, please, God, I know I don't deserve it, but please, warm her heart towards me, please. And she forgave me, and I knew that God listened to my prayer, and that God loved me and he forgave me. I brought a contrite heart, and that's what it means in the forgiving nature of Jesus, is that we bring it to him. And that's why he died, because he loved us that much. Once I understood the healing nature of forgiveness and how Jesus forgave me, it made me not want to be in the world anymore. People had tried to help me over the years, but my heart was so hard, and I couldn't believe that God honestly forgave me. I couldn't forgive me. I walked away from my Creator, and he left me anyway, and it made me realize I just wanted to be free of all the world, free of all of the idols in my life.
Oh, mothers, let's go down.